During this course series, we implemented two components. They are getting started component and attribute directive component. In app.component.html, let me uncomment getting started component and comment attribute directive component. I am saving the file. Once the page reloads, the content of getting started component gets displayed in the browser. Let me now swap the comments in app.component.html and save the file. After the page reload, we can see the content of attribute directive component displayed. Now I am uncommenting both of the component selectors and saving the file. After the page reload, we can see both the components displayed one below the other. Now the question that we may have is that, is it possible to display one of the component of my choice without changing the code? This can be implemented using routing, which is what I will demonstrate in this video. In app.component.html, I am commenting the selectors of both the components. In the next line, I am including router-outlet tag. This tag is going to help us dynamically include either getting started component or attribute directive component. Then I am opening app-routing.module.ts from src/app folder. This file is in the same folder where we have app.module.ts, app.component.ts, and app.component.html. In this file, in line number 5, we can see routes defined as empty array. In this array, as the first array item, I'm going to include an object. This object is going to have a property named path with the value as getting-started. As a next property in the object, I'm including the property name as component. After colon of this property, I'm typing getting, and we can see the getting started component in the suggestion list, and I am selecting that which imports the respective component. By the end of this line, I am including a comma so that I can define one more object into this routes array. I am copying the object definition without the comma and pasting it in the next line. I am changing the path property value as attribute-directive, then the component as attribute directive component. I am saving all the files using shortcut key. After the page reload, we can see that the web page is blank. In the address bar after localhost colon 4200, I am including a slash followed by getting-started and pressing enter key. We can see the getting started component displayed. Now in the address bar, I am going to remove getting-started. I am typing attribute-directive and pressing enter key. We can see the attribute directive component displayed. We can see that it is possible to display a specific component of my choice without having the need to change the code. Let me summarize the changes done to implement routing so that you can implement these changes in your Angular application. Comment existing selectors and include router-outlet tag in app.component.html. In app-routing.module.ts, include these two objects in the routes array. Then save both the files. Once the page reloads, try to change the URL in the address bar with the path name that we have included in app-routing.module.ts to check if the respective component is displayed. In the next series of videos, we will get more information about how this routing implementation works.